Welcome everyone. During this session, we will discuss some of the most important applications of the physics in our life. So a new topic, that is for biomagnetism. So we have to see the purpose of this short discussion is just and only to give you a concept of biomagnetism in the universe, how it is playing a very much important role in our life. So what the biomagnetism is and how it's playing a very much role in our life, and how different birds and unicellular organisms are also using this technique, which is purely based on the physics laws, to find out the location and other types of movement. So here we are. Certain bacteria biologically produce single domain grain of magnetic, a compound equivalent to iron ore, that are string together to form internal compasses. They then use these compass to detect the dip of Earth's magnetic field. Equipped with sense of direction, the organisms are able to locate food supplies. Amazingly, those bacteria that live south of the equator build the same single domain magnets as their counterparts that live north of the equator. But so this is the concept of north and south pole of the magnet. But they align them in the opposite direction to coincide with the opposite direction. Magnetic field in the southern hemisphere. Bacteria are not the only living organisms that built in magnetic compass. Pigeons have recently been found to have multiple domain magnetite magnets within their skulls that are connected with a large number of nerves to the pigeon brain. Pigeons have a magnetic sense. Here the pigeons. Pigeons have the magnetic sense to locate the direction. Pigeons have a magnetic sense. Not only can they send the longitudinal direction along Earth's magnetic field, they can also detect latitude by the dip of the Earth field. Magnetic materials have also been found in abdomen of bees. Those behavior is affected by small magnetic fields. Some wasps, monarch butterflies, sea turtle, and fish join the ranks of creatures with a magnetic sense. Magnetic crystals that resemble the crystalline found in magnetic bacteria have been found in human brain. No one knows if these are linked to our sensations, like the creatures mentioned above and which I have discussed. We may share the common sense of the magnetic. So here are some of the interesting applications of the magnet. So look at these are the types of the magnetic therapy used for the treatment of different types of the diseases as well. If you look at the magnets, types of the magnets, if you look at the concept of magnetism in case of human beings, how these are playing a very much important role. If you look at the pigeon and turtle and other creatures are also having a magnet in their brains through which they can find out the location, the position. So here are some of the examples of the magnet. If you look at these are the magnets used for therapies purposes, because human brain and human body also have some magnetic domains present. So this is one of the examples, healthy cell. If you look at the formation of the sequence of the cells and the ions of the charges present, potassium and sodium in a healthy person, and if a person is have a diseased cell, look at the distribution of the positive and the negative ions in case of a diseased person. So here these are the condition magnetic field therapy strives to bring about. So this is the purpose of magnetic field therapy, which is used to locate or correct the position of the ions, which are, if you look at the, compare these two, healthy cell and the diseased cell, this is the distribution of the ions, which are already, compounds are in our body, and the compounds break up into the ions, and these ions have special types of formation. If the formation is disturbed, then the cell is said to be the diseased type of cell. Then such types of the magnetic therapies are carried out to make some types of the arrangements to correct the diseased part. So with this, I thank you very much. I have given you some of the ideas for biomagnetism, and this biomagnetism research can go much more for the benefits of the human beings by making more developments, making more researches in this field. This will be a very important area for our future to come, and to make our life more safer from this bacteria and other types of viruses which are badly affecting our human life. I thank you very much.